Hi, this is Breno from Dell Technologies. In this short video, we learn about Data Protection Advisor, or DPA for short. This data protection reporting software is offered by Dell as part of the broader data protection suite. We'll also discuss some of the advantages of DPA and different ways in which we can configure DPA. DPA is included in the Data Protection Suite to monitor and report a wide range of Dell and non-Dell products. It provides customers with business metrics and real-time alerts to manage and simplify the data protection infrastructure. As we'll see in this video, DPA can collect raw data from many different areas of your environment, including backup applications, replication appliances, virtual infrastructure, dedupe targets, SanDisk, servers, and databases. Using advanced technology, DPA digests that raw data, analyzes it in real time, and makes sense of it by connecting the dots between different parts of the environment. For example, it helps to answer questions like, is that new virtual machine protected? Are all the LUNs for that database replicated? Is this backup job significantly smaller than the average size of this job over the past few days? You can run ad hoc reports in DPA, or you can get them by email every morning. You can generate alerts using SNMP traps or email, and you can publish the alerts to your SharePoint portal. And aside from telling your backup administrator which jobs failed or succeeded, DPA also tells your stakeholders that your backup and restore success rate is trending up compared to past month, tells your internal audit team that you're complying with relevant legislation, tells your accounting team how much to charge for your customers for the data that you're protecting for them, and tells your IT manager that you're running out of capacity on your data domain. DPA provides visibility, predictability, and reporting across multiple functions of your data protection environment. DPA's modern HTML5 web-based UI is fast and intuitive, providing easy execution of common functions, such as report edits and debugging. Next, let's look at some of the features and advantages that DPA offers. DPA's data protection solution support is broad and deep, encompassing on-premises environments and virtual and public cloud environments such as GCP, AWS, and Azure. It also integrates with backup applications from Dell, such as PowerProtect Data Manager, Arma, Networker, and non-Dell backup products, such as from Commvault and Veritas. It also supports Dell primary storage integration through ProtectPoint, along with databases, tape platforms, replication appliances, enterprise applications, and network components. For a complete list of supported products and applications, see the DPA compatibility guide on the eLab Navigator page. See the links below this video. Next advantage is having a unified data protection management solution for all your backup applications, replication appliances, virtual infrastructure, dedupe targets, SanDisk, servers, switches, databases, and cloud infrastructure. DPA offers rapidly scalable, centralized multi-tenant data protection management. It also supports thousands of tenants on a single DPA instance without performance degradation. We can consolidate all operational backup and replication information into a single data store with access from a single console via dashboards. With DPA, you always know you can recover to your service levels, removing uncertainty and mitigating risk. DPA uses a proactive analysis engine to get to the source of recovery problems quickly by driving the solution's monitoring, alerting, troubleshooting, optimization, capacity planning, and reporting. DPA provides instant recoverability and service level status, as well as reports available at the click of a button. The proactive analysis engine constantly monitors incoming data against a variety of rules, looking for failures, threshold exceptions, and developing conditions. The analysis engine can look for a failure on a critical host, repeated backup failures, growth of a backup that will exceed the backup window, missed SLAs, and resource utilization thresholds. It can also monitor replication environments for gaps in policy or configuration that will cause a recovery to fail. You can use or customize the standard rule set to suit your requirements, and can monitor any of the resources or policies that DPA supports. And starting with version 19.8, DPA can proactively detect cyber threat anomalies in your environment. Finally, let's look at the three configuration types in DPA. The most common type is a standalone configuration, which has three main components: application server, data store server, and data collection agent. DPA analyzes and processes the data from the monitored application to generate reports. The number and location of these agents depends on the number and type of objects being monitored and location of these objects. Data collection can be remote as well. DPA's simple split install deployments are architected for future growth as well as for large, complex environments with more immediate scalability and recovery requirements. The next configuration type is federated reporting, designed for summary level reporting. Federated reporting provides aggregated reporting across multiple DPA servers, a useful feature if you have a large environment with many DPA servers. If all of these servers are in different geographies or in different customer groups, you may want to run a single report across all the DPA servers. instead of running the same report separately and repeatedly across each of the DPA server groups and then merging the reports, federated reporting merges all of the DPA servers into one super tree structure on a DPA server that you designate as the federated DPA server. And from this federated DPA server, you can run the federated report. The last configuration type is data store replication, which provides functionality for DPA to maintain a replica copy of the primary data store for resilience against a single point of data store failure. You can continue to use DPA in the event of a failure of the primary data store with minimal intervention. Please note that DPA is ending support for the application clustering feature after DPA version 19.7. For more information, check out the links below this video to the DPA product page and the DPA compatibility guide. This was a brief introduction to Data Protection Advisor from Dell Technologies.